Today we're going to be taking a look at AkiFlow, and we're going to be diving into a bit of a beginner's guide so that you can understand the basics of AkiFlow, but also work out whether it's right for you. So we're going to dive into what AkiFlow is, then we're going to look at a few of the features to get a bit of a grasp of what it's about, and finalize with who AkiFlow is probably best suited for. Welcome everyone, my name is Francesco. I'm excited to dive into AkiFlow with you all. If you are new here, do hit subscribe. And if you do want to find more productivity tools or in the hunt for AkiFlow-like tools, you can go over to Tool Finder as well as find the beginner's guide to AkiFlow linked below. So I wanted to start by talking about what AkiFlow is. And very simply, AkiFlow is a to-do list application that combines other to-do list applications in one location. Now, I sort of call it a daily planner application, which basically means you get your tasks and your calendar in one location. But you can also use it as a consolidation tool, which means you can bring other applications like Todoist, like ClickUp, your Gmail inbox, and items like that, all into one location to capture and manage your tasks in one spot. So I want to jump over to the laptop to dive into some of the basic features and guide you around AkiFlow so you can understand it in a bit more detail. Again, if you're looking into AkiFlow, you can find our Tool Finder profile on it, linked below as well. So here we are with AkiFlow, and it is available on a few different devices, which you can find in the link in description. Naturally, the application itself is very nice to look at. It's very simple in its structure. As I mentioned, on the left-hand side, you have your tasks, and on the right-hand side, you have your calendar view, which allows you to peek into what you see in the week ahead. Now, the great news is if I go over to the settings page, which you can find in the top right-hand corner, I can integrate it with whatever calendar I find suitable. And the default calendar brings through other calendars that you might have as well, which is perfect for seeing all of your events, as well as what conference tool you would like to use to be able to link up meetings in the future. So as I mentioned, you can use it as a great calendar blocking system. So any tasks you create here, you can add them to your calendar. Let's go ahead and do that. So let's say create AkiFlow review, being on my to-do list. You can see that the to-dos pop up here, allowing you to drag it into the calendar. Now, one thing you've noted there is that it's now scheduled on the calendar. And very simply, if I click into the item, this lives in AkiFlow. So you can see all of the details about the task. You can even set a deadline, as well as adding a description and a link. But you can also give it almost a place to belong, like almost a list. And that inside of AkiFlow is labels. Labels help you to organize your work. In this case, it might be editing. And if I go over into editing, I can see that task belong here. Now, with the calendar blocking, I can move this. I can move my events around as well, which is perfect. So that makes two-way syncing a lot easier. And you notice up in the right-hand corner, you can see the syncing finishing as well, which means that I can sync with other applications. So what other applications can I sync with? Well, there's actually a range of different applications. If I go to tasks inside of settings, you can modify some integrations here, but integrations is what we're looking for. Google Calendar, Notion, Todoist, and ClickUp, I've already got clicked up or set up, and you can see some of the native integrations you have here, as well as a few you can add with Zapier and IFTTT. Now, what's cool is once I've got them connected, I can bring and set up certain amounts of rules. We've got other guides on that, but you can see that I can set up some integrations and really customize it, like configure it to what actually comes in and where they actually go in the location. So what do they look like when they're actually into the system? If I go to all tasks, you can see a few that I've had in the past. Like for example, this one, user feedback, Paul Jenkins. If I click an inbox, I can see it. And it's part of this work AkiFlow example that I can link out to and find later. But most importantly, I can actually bring these into my to-do list, meaning that I can focus on them during my day. Now, you may notice this has a slight hue around the edges, and that's because you can set things like goals for the day and priorities as well on top of tasks that you have inside of AkiFlow. But going back to that consolidation concept, you can see that this task is from Notion, and you can even bring in email items from Gmail and many more accounts, so you can literally make this your hub of task management. Now, other things that might be helpful when you're using AkiFlow is that you can actually customize the calendar a little bit more, like you can change the views, hide the weekends, show temporary time zones, and a bit more detail like that. One thing you can also do is go to the upcoming view, which is great for being able to see things at a glance, but also almost in Kanban style, so you can see and plan ahead. What's nice as well is I can see items appear in the right-hand side as well, and I can even see the inbox and other details too. Now, AkiFlow is pretty neat for being to organize stuff with other people because you can use your share availability function, which means you can select some times, save and copy them, and they can book that meeting with somebody else, which saves you a bit of time being able to create booking links or in email, being able to find that for later. And to finish off, there is a daily planning tool, which allows you to see what you did the day before, what progression you've made forward, and also what events and tasks you have as well, essentially hand-holding you through planning in a rituals type of sense, which is cool. There's also nice features like daily statistics, quite an advanced settings page, which will help you go into a bit more detail on pretty much everything. And finally, an inbox, which allows you to add tasks here, and a good command center for being able to plan and be able to save time saving tasks into your AkiFlow. So that was some of the basic features on AkiFlow, but who is this best suited for? Well, very simply, AkiFlow is designed for those who want to consolidate all of their tasks into one location, but also want to see their tasks inside of their calendar too. For those who really like calendar blocking, this is a great tool for that. But I would say this is perfect for those who are maybe working on multiple projects for multiple clients, or maybe even in their company, and they want to be able to store all of their to-dos in one location in a more unique way of organizing it. And although the pricing of AkiFlow is slightly higher than applications like Todoist and TickTick, it definitely brings together more of the experiences that you may have with a more premium to-do list application. So if you're looking at this application, I probably recommend it in a scenario where you invest in your to-do list app and your calendar much more in managing your day's work versus someone that might be happy or comfortable with a lighter weight experience. So if you're interested in exploring AkiFlow further or alternatives to AkiFlow, you can find them linked below over on Toolfinder. I am very happy to have helped you out today with this beginner's guide to AkiFlow, but if you're in the hunt for more beginner's guide, you can search them on YouTube or you can go over to Toolfinder and find more. Thank you very much, folks. Please do make sure to subscribe. It was Francesco D'Alessio here, and I'll see you in a future video. Cheerio, folks. Bye.